And welcome back to News Talk. Now, another in our series of Vote 2010 debates. The race for mayor of the district and governor of Maryland attracting most of the headlines these days, but there are a ton of interesting and hotly contested races down ballot that voters will also decide on September 14th. Today, we spotlight another of those contests. Our focus this time, the race for the Maryland Senate in Montgomery County's District 17. This map showing where 17 is located. As you can see, it's largely Rockville and the Mid-County. Democrat Jennie Forehand has represented this district in Annapolis since 1978. She's being challenged by former state delegate and fellow Democrat Cheryl Kagan. Good to have both of you here. You talk Metro, you took Metro, and I think we'd do it again.
Yes.
Based on your experience of this morning.
Absolutely.
And Cheryl, you decided to drive, and next time you're taking Metro, right? You made it.
I did.
Thank
glad
you.
To be here.
Bruce. Good to
Thank
have both
you.
Of you here. Yeah. We have a compressed amount of time because of traffic issues. Let me get right into it, and I'm going to push you both hard during this time so we can make the most of our time together. Senator Forehand, you've been in Annapolis a long time. Give us one or two of the Jennie Forehand greatest hits, the areas where you feel you made a difference for your constituents, your county.
Oh, I've done so many things, but I think that I've made life a lot better for all of our constituents, a lot healthier. One of the things I did early on was get the state to become smoke-free. I didn't do it alone, but I was one of the leaders. And then also
in terms of bars and restaurants.
Yes, and bars and restaurants and the Oriole Stadium, and it's everywhere in public areas. And also made it easier for people to keep their health insurance by being sure that genetic information did not cause people to the insurance companies to cancel insurance. And I've been really involved in an awful lot of consumer issues. And also, I saved a lot of jobs with my bill that repealed the tax on computer services. There were a lot of companies that were threatening to leave the state. And that was one of the ones that I could go on and on and on all day.
Cheryl Kagan, with every item that Senator Forehand just listed, you're shaking your head. Why?
Well, Jennie has done some good things in her 32 years in the legislature, but that was the past. In the present and the future, we've got some hard economic times. We've got fiscal crisis. We have budget issues we've got to address. We're going to have a lot of budget cuts that need to be made and taxes that are going to be increased. We have to make sure that Montgomery County is not seen as the state's piggy bank, and we're going to have to really focus, ask the hard questions, and make difficult decisions. That's the kind of legislator I was during the 8 years in the House, and that's what we need again.
But if she was effective, if she has been effective till now, why would the next 4 years not be any different?
With all due respect, I think her focus is not where it should be. Talking about stopping smoking or genetic discrimination, those are both great issues. But we have to focus on the fiscal issues, the pocketbook issues. That's about jobs, economic development, and budget cuts. We have always taken the hit disproportionately when budgets are cut, and we've always had the tax hit increases hit us disproportionately. Jennie tries to take credit for repealing the tech tax, the computer tax, but she was the key vote that actually enacted such a tax and did cause jobs to leave our state, companies to decide not to move to Maryland, and that's a problem.
Senator?
She has cost us jobs before she tried to save things.
I corrected that. The bill to repeal Too late. The tax. The bill to repeal the tax was done after before the tax actually went into play. And my top jobs, the question was not about that. The question was what were some of the things. My top issues are the economy and jobs and education. And it was my bill, the Biotech Investment Incentive Act, several years ago with Brian Feldman in the House, that has really helped come and bring more biotech companies into the state and have a lot of opportunities for jobs that are really good. That Investment Incentive Act gives money to companies that are coming to the state or that are already here but need to expand and can prove that they're going to be successful and have a lot more jobs available.
There are 47 members of the Senate. There are a handful of committees. So clearly, not everyone is going to be a committee chair or a vice chair. But classically, folks with a lot of experience, folks who've been there a while, eventually do get a committee. You have never chaired a committee. Is that a sign that the Senate president doesn't have faith in your leadership?
Absolutely not. I don't want to chair a committee. The committee that I'm on, Judicial Proceedings Committee, is the one where I'm very, very effective. And because and I'm not an attorney, so I would definitely not be chair of that. However, I do chair the Federal Relations Committee. At one time, I chaired the Management of Public Funds. I'm on some really important committees. I'm also represent the Senate on the Regional Transportation Planning Board. So transportation has really been one of my major issues through the years.
Bruce, not only is Jennie not the chair of one of the four standing committees, she's not a vice chair, she's not a chair of a subcommittee, nor has she ever even chaired the Montgomery County Senate delegation, which you only need four more votes to be able to chair. She's been vice chair a bunch of times, and then junior members have passed over here her to become chair. The Joint Committee on Federal Relations is a wonderful sounding title.
So the issue is what?
It's an honorary committee that really does very little.
So the big picture issue from your perspective
is effectiveness. We need someone who's going to be in the back room, who's going to be at the table when decisions are made. The committee that Jennie is, some of the work that she does is honorary, is official, is dog and pony shows, is very nice. But the Committee on Federal Relations, once a year everyone goes to Capitol Hill and they smile and wave, but it does not bring legislation, it does not have significant jurisdiction, nor is it turned to for expertise when it comes to conference committees or budget reports.
I'm in the back room continually. What my opponent is saying is that she really thinks that she has to be in the leadership to be effective. I have been a worker bee. I have been very effective. I have the trust and credibility with my colleagues to do everything that needs to be done. That's why I've been very, very successful with these things. And I believe that when Cheryl was in the House, she was not in any leadership positions. And my whole life is not tied up with trying to be the top person. My whole work is to be a public servant and to do the things that our constituents need to have done for them.
The endorsements, let me, because our time is so compressed, the endorsements, and only give me two or three that you're proudest of this cycle.
Okay. The Montgomery County Teachers Association, the retired teachers, the AFL-CIO.
There's three.
Okay. The League of Conservation Voters and Sierra Club for my leadership on the environment.
Just
Jennie is the second worst
environmental
record in the delegation. Marilyn NARAL, because they see me as a champion for women's reproductive rights.
Who did the chamber do? Or has the chamber?
The Bethesda Chevy Chase Chamber of Commerce, which is the only chamber that has endorsed
me. And the county chamber is held off.
They have not done anything yet.
In terms of what has been traditionally the county's number one priority in Annapolis, maintaining the status quo on education funding, as people know, the local school districts pay teacher salaries, the state picks up pension and Social Security. Some people are saying, okay, wave the white flag of surrender and cut the best deal you can in terms of a different arrangement going forward. Other people say, hey, the fiscal reality is such that we can't continue the way we've been going. What's the answer for the next 4 years?
We cannot shift the burden from the state to the county. The county has already been dealing with significant budget shortfalls and cutting programs already. That also has an impact on our municipalities. Rockville, Gaithersburg, and Garrett Park are already struggling to continue to provide the great services they do. We cannot shift that burden.
Senator?
I agree with that.
Are there other issues on which you disagree? We have a minute and a half left, enough for one more go around. If there's some issue, because you guys have been in a number of these debates, I know, and you know you're sort of primed in terms of the areas of disagreement.
Well, in another debate, it was determined that there were no major issues that we disagreed on. It was just style. And I think that my style is low-key, and that's why I am very, very effective. And I am really focusing on the jobs and the economy and the education especially. And I think that we have a great time there. And by the way, I was just speaking with two of the members of the Public Service Commission about the issues related to the storm and the electricity outages, and that was one of the things another of your programs mentioned. And I wanted to add that I have been very involved in that. And where I live, we have underground wiring, but we had outages too.
Delegate Kagan.
We have tough times. These economic crises that we're facing right now are unlike any that we faced in my lifetime. We're going to need to make tough decisions, and pushing the right button most of the times is not enough. We need a legislator, a state senator in Annapolis, who's going to stand up and speak out, who's going to be an advocate, make sure that people understand that Montgomery County has needs too, and make sure that we get our fair share.
Former delegate Cheryl Kagan, incumbent State Senator Jennie Forehand, Democrats running in the District 17 State Senate primary. Thank you both for coming in and sharing your views.
Thank you.
Good conversation in a compressed period of time. We appreciate both of you
Thank
joining
you.
Us today.
Thank
Applause
you.
Here.
Thank you very
Back
much.
With a program note right after this.